Hello students, a very very good morning to all of y'all and welcome to the Maths Camp by Mahesh Tutorials. I welcome all of y'all on behalf of Mahesh Tutorials to the Maths Camp. Student, today we are going to do the last part of this chapter and that's very very important for your 10th standard. So let us start with that part, student. We are first going to revise isosceles triangle theorem. First, students, we are going to revise isosceles triangle theorem, which we have already done in our previous lecture. Okay, so let us quickly revise the theorem. We all know we had a statement called as if two sides of a triangle are congruent, then the angles opposite to them are also congruent. So, students, we are going to understand this statement, which we have already done in our previous class. So let us quickly revise, students. We are talking about a geometrical figure, triangle. So we have triangle ABC. If two sides of a triangle are congruent. So students, what do you mean by two sides of a triangle? Let us take two sides, that is AB and AC. We know AB and AC, both of them are congruent. That's already given to us. Then what will be its consequence? What will be its result? Then the angle opposite to them are also congruent. So student, tell me AB, side AB ke opposite, konsa angle hai? Superb, it is angle C. And AC ke opposite, konsa angle hai? AC ke opposite, konsa angle hai? Yes, it is angle B. So what do we know about angle B and angle C? They both are congruent. So angle B is congruent to angle C. So students, in a triangle, if two sides are congruent, then the angles opposite to them are also congruent. And the reason for the same will be isosceles triangle theorem. Okay. Let us proceed further, students. We are doing practice set 3.3, question number 1. It's a very important sum which can come in your school exam for 3 marks. So I want each and every student to pay attention for the sum. Okay. So students, we are given with the figure. The question says, find the value of X and Y using the given information in the figure and also find the measure of angle ABD, and you have to find measure of angle ACD. So students, first we'll concentrate on the values of X and Y. X belongs to the first triangle, student. So concentrate on the first triangle. Tell me, what is the name of the triangle? Yes, superb. The name of the triangle is ABC. So in triangle ABC, students, what do you observe? Look at the identical marks. What do you observe? Yes, superb. AB is congruent to AC. What did we observe? AB is congruent to AC. Tell me, students, in a triangle, if two sides are equal, then what can you conclude about the angles opposite to them? We have just learned, in a triangle, if two sides are congruent, then the angles opposite to them are also congruent. Okay. So students will get angle ABC congruent to angle ACB. Reason will be isosceles triangle theorem. Substitute the value, students. Tell me ABC. ABC ki jagah pe kya aayega? X. And tell me, students, ACB. ACB ki jagah pe kya aayega? Superb, 50. So students, what is the value of X we have got? The value of X which we have got is X is equal to 50. Superb, students. Now tell me, students, look at the second triangle, that is triangle DBC, and tell me, students, what will be value of Y? Come on, let me see how many students are giving answer. What will be value of Y? Great, superb. Others, please reply. Yes, the value of Y will be 60 degree. So students, how will you present it? Same way. First thing, name of the triangle. What is the name of the triangle? DBC. So in triangle DBC, tell me students, what do you observe? Look at the identical marks. Yes, two sides are equal. So I write down student side BD is congruent to side DC. Side BD is congruent to side DC. If two sides are equal, then the angles opposite to them are also equal. So student, tell me which two angles will be equal? Yes, superb. That is angle DBC will be congruent to angle DCB. Superb, students. Reason for that will be isosceles triangle theorem. Okay. So students will substitute the values y is equal to 60 and we mark this as result number 2. Okay. Student, all of you all will draw the figure. You all can see the figure which is there. Draw the figure and write down the solution. Students, I'll give you just 2 minutes to draw the figure and write down the solution. Quickly draw the figure, refer to the solution, and then try to write the entire solution on your own. Yes, students, please be a little fast. Students, you can mark this sum as an important sum in your textbook for 3 marks, okay? This sum can also come in the form of activity, or it can also come in the form of multiple choice questions, which majority schools are asking because of this pandemic situation. Yes, students, please draw the figure and write down the solution. Okay, students, if you are done till here, please try to solve how will you get measure angle ABD. Think how will you get measure angle ABD and think how will you get measure angle ACD. Think on that. If you want, you can do rough work and give me the answer. Okay, last 1 minute, students, those who are writing, please be a little fast. Okay, students, let's proceed further. Now, students, we have to find measure angle ABD. So observe at angle ABD. Tell me, student, is this angle ABD made up of two small angles? Yes, angle ABD is made up of two small angles. Tell me, students, which are the two small angles? Yes, superb. It is angle ABC plus angle CBD. We are adding two small angles and getting the value of bigger angles. So the reason will be angle addition property. That is x plus 60. We substitute the value x plus 60. Student, look at equation number 1 and tell me what is the value of x. X हमें कितना मिला था? Yes, X हमें मिला था 50. So 50 plus 60. 50 plus 60 will give me 110. So angle ABD is 110 degree. Similarly, students, look at angle ACD and tell me, is ACD made up of two angles? Yes, super. Which are the two angles? It is angle ACB plus angle DCB. Reason will be angle addition property. The reason will be angle addition property. We substitute the values, students. Look at the values. 50 plus y. What is y? Look at equation number 2. Y ka value hume kitna mila tha? 60. So 50 plus 60, that is again 110. So measure angle ACD is 110 degree. Okay. Students, quickly complete the sum by writing last 8 lines. I want all the students to quickly complete the sum. Be little fast. Okay, I hope all of you are done with this. Let's proceed further, students. We move on to the next sum. Let us, students, start with the next sum. I hope all of you have written this. Those who are still writing, last 30 seconds, please complete it fast. Okay. Now, students, let us see the next sum. The next sum is a very, very simple and a very easy sum. Practice set 3.4, question number 5. Okay. Prove that an equilateral triangle is equiangular. Students, what do you mean by equilateral triangle? A triangle in which three sides are equal. So, students, I have triangle PQR as an equilateral triangle. When I say it's an equilateral triangle, that means all the three sides are equal. Now, students, we have to prove this equilateral triangle is an equiangular. What do you mean by the word equiangular? Means equal angles. We have to prove in this equilateral triangle, all angles are equal. Okay? Equiangular ka matlab hota hai equal angles. So, we have to prove that all the three angles, that is measure angle P, measure angle Q and measure angle R, they are equal. Okay. Let us see, students, how will you prove this? It's a very simple thing. Please concentrate here. We will concentrate on triangle PQR. Students, if you remember, we have just studied a theorem. In a triangle, if two sides are congruent, so observe, in triangle PQR, two sides are congruent. Which two sides are congruent? PQ and PR. So in triangle PQR, PQ is congruent to PR. That is reason will be sides of equilateral triangle. We know each side of equilateral triangles are congruent to each other. Now students, observe the figure. In this triangle, I have two sides to be congruent. Just concentrate on these two sides. In a triangle, if two sides are congruent, then angles opposite to them are also congruent. So angle Q will be congruent to angle R. Tell me, students, what will be the reason for this? If two sides of a triangle are congruent, then the angles opposite to them are also congruent. So reason kya aega? Yes, superb. The reason will be isosceles triangle theorem. Similarly, students, I'll take another two sides. Okay. I'll take PR and QR. So in PR is congruent to QR. Reason will be sides of equilateral triangle. Students, tell me if two sides are congruent. If two sides are congruent, then the angles opposite to them will also be congruent. So angle Q will be congruent to angle P. Result number 2, isosceles triangle theorem. Students, observe result number 1 and result number 2. Q is congruent to which angle? R. And in equation number 2, Q is congruent to which angle? P. That means from equation number 1 and 2, I get angle P congruent to angle Q congruent to angle R. That means all the three angles are equal. How did I got this? By comparing result number 1 and 2. So from 1 and 2. And if all sides are equal, then the triangle is an equiangular triangle. Equiangular ka matlab hota hai equal angles. Okay. Students, I'll just give you 2 minutes. Quickly draw the figure. Write given to proof and proof. Again, this is an important sum which can come in your school exams for 2 marks. Okay. So students, first you need to draw the figure. Then you need to write given, then to proof, and then the proof. Okay. Students, 2 minutes, please start writing. All the students, please start writing. Students, you need to draw the figure with scale and pencil. Underline the 3 headings, that is given, to proof, and proof. All the 3 headings will be double underlined with scale and pencil. Okay, students, I hope all of you have written this sum. Those who are still writing, quickly complete the sum. Figure given to proof, proof. Given to proof, proof. All the 3 headings need to be double underlined with scale and pencil. Okay, students, let us proceed further. Okay. Students, now we are going to start with the last part of the chapter, which is very, very important for your 10th standard. Okay. In 10th standard, the first chapter which you are going to learn is similarity. The basics of similarity we are going to learn in our 9th standard. So students, I want everyone to be very, very attentive for the next part. Okay. Now students, let us start with the next part of the chapter. The last and most easiest part of the chapter, that is similarity. Okay. Students, let us start with that. Now, students, first we'll do a small activity, and I want everyone to be very, very, very interactive. Okay. So, So students, if you observe, I have taken a circle, I have taken stars, and I have taken a square. Okay, observe to this two circle. We have one circle with pink color, second circle with blue color. Observe this. If I take the first circle and place it on the second circle, okay, tell me students, what did you observe? What did you observe? Okay, I'm getting answers. They get fit into each other. Very good. They are overlapping each other. Very good. Yes, they are coinciding each other. Okay. They are getting exactly fit into each other. They are coming one on above each other. Okay. Observe same thing with stars and square. What did you observe, students? Again, they are coinciding. They are getting fit into each other. Why this is happening, students? If I take circle and place it on square, will it get coincide each other? Will it get fit into each other? No. If I take a bigger circle and place it on the smaller circle, will they get fit into each other? No. Will they coincide each other? No. So why, students, these figures are coinciding each other? Because these are the figures having same shape and same size. These are the figures which are having same shape and same size. So students, figures which have same shape and same size. Figures which have same shape and same size. Such figures are known as congruent figures. So students, if the figures are congruent, their shape and size, both of them will be same. Shape bhi same hona chahiye, size bhi same hona chahiye. Okay. Now students, let us study about similar object. What do you mean by the word similar object? Okay. Students, if I take a Taj Mahal, the original Taj Mahal, and there is a small showpiece of Taj Mahal, both of them look same. They have same shape. Okay. But their size are different. If you look here and this, दोनों का शेप सेम, एग्जैक्टली सेम शेप है, बट देयर साइज इज डिफरेंट. ओके, सेम वे इफ आई टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑफ अ अर्थ एंड अ ग्लोब, ओके, बोथ ऑफ देम इज हैविंग अ सेम शेप, बोथ ऑफ देम इज हैविंग अ सेम शेप, बट देयर साइज इज डिफरेंट. अर्थ का इतना बड़ा साइज है, ग्लोब वी कैन होल्ड इन आवर हैंड ऑल्सो. ओके, सेम वे इफ आई टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एयरवेज, एरोप्लेन, ओके, एंड जो छोटा बच्चों का खेलने का एरोप्लेन आता है, बोथ ऑफ देम आर हैविंग सेम शेप, बोथ ऑफ देम आर हैविंग सेम शेप, बट बोथ ऑफ देम आर हैविंग डिफरेंट साइज. ओके, फिगर्स हूज शेप इज सेम, दोनों का शेप सेम है, बट साइज मे और मे नॉट बी सिमिलर. ओके, सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सिमिलर ऑब्जेक्ट्स? स्टूडेंट्स, टू ऑब्जेक्ट विच हैज सेम शेप, दोनों का सेम शेम है, ओके, बट देयर साइज कैन बी डिफरेंट. इट कैन बी सेम और इट कैन नॉट बी सेम. ओके, इट कैन बी सिमिलर, इट कैन नॉट बी सिमिलर. सच फिगर्स, सच ऑब्जेक्ट विच हैव सेम शेप एंड डिफरेंट साइज, सेम शेप एंड डिफरेंट साइज, साइज कैन बी सेम और साइज कैन बी डिफरेंट, सच ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर कॉल्ड अ सिमिलर ऑब्जेक्ट्स. Such objects are called as similar objects. Okay, students, let us take a triangle ABC. If you observe, I have taken a right angle triangle ABC. मैं same triangle को zoom कर देता हूँ. Okay, and I change the name to PQR. What do you observe, students? We have a same shape figure. दोनों का shape same है, but size is different. Such figures are called as similar figures. Okay, such figures are called as similar figures. So student, triangle ABC and triangle PQR have same shape. Dono ka shape same hai, but their size is different. But their size is different. Maine ABC ko kya kiya hai? Zoom kiya hai. So dono ka shape same rahega, but size is different. So we call such figures to be similar figures. So write down triangle ABC is similar to
is similar to triangle PRQ. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PRQ. Student, instead of writing is similar to, we have a sign for similar. Okay. If you can see this wave sign is nothing but it's a sign for similar. So how do you read this? Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PRQ. Okay. Now, students, if triangles are similar, we have a relation between their angles, between their corresponding angles. Corresponding ka matlab humne pehle bhi padha, between their matching angles and between their matching sides. Angles ke beech mein bhi relation hota hai, sides ke beech mein bhi relation hota hai. Let us study that relation, student. If two triangles are similar, then their corresponding angle, corresponding angles are congruent. So student, tell me, look at the figure. A ka corresponding angle, which is the corresponding angle of A, matlab matching angle of A. Yes, it is P. So angle A will be congruent to angle P. Next, which is the corresponding angle of B? Students, tell me, which is the corresponding angle of B? Yes, it is R. And which is the corresponding angle of C? Yes, it is Q. So students, whenever the triangles are similar, their corresponding angles are congruent. So students, whenever you have two triangles to be similar, what is the relation between their corresponding angles? Their corresponding angles are congruent. Okay, matching angles are congruent. So whenever you have two triangles similar, what is the relation between their corresponding angles? They are congruent. Okay. Same way, students, the reason is corresponding angles of similar triangles are congruent. Each corresponding angle, okay, of a similar triangle will always be congruent. Like you can see in the figure, A will be congruent to P, B will be congruent to R, and C will be congruent to angle Q. Okay, students, you all can look at this name also. Look at the first alphabet, which is the first alphabet A. Aur yahan pe first alphabet kaun sa hai? P. So angle A will be congruent to angle P. Angle B ka corresponding angle kaun sa hai? R. And angle C ka corresponding angle kaun sa hai? Q. So students, here it becomes very important that you have to write the name as per one-to-one correspondence. You have to write the name as per one-to-one correspondence. Okay. Now students, let us take the measurements. We have 8.5. जो PQ है वो उसका double zoom किया है मैंने. जितना original cell था उसका double zoom किया है. 8.5 का double कितना होगा? 17. 5 का double 10. And 10 का double 20. Okay. So students, observe the figure here. All of you will observe the figure here. What is the relation between their sides? जैसे हम लोगों ने corresponding angles का relation पढ़ा. Whenever triangles are similar, corresponding angles are congruent. Students, same way we are going to study a relation between their corresponding sides. Okay. So students, we take AB. We have AB upon PR. AB ka matching side concept PR. So students, we take AB upon PR. That is 8.5 upon 17. 8.5 ones are, 8.5 twos are. So students, AB upon PR, hame kitna mila? 1 upon 2. Tell me students, which is the corresponding side of BC? BC ka corresponding side. Yes, students, it is QR. So BC upon QR, that is 5 upon 10. 5 upon 10 will also be 1 upon 2. Tell me student, which is the matching side of AC? AC ka matching side kaun sa hai? Yes, it is PQ. So AC upon PQ. 10 upon 20, 0, 0 gets cancelled. Answer is 1 upon 2. So students, observe the each sides which are in proportion. Okay. AB upon PR is also 1 upon 2. BC upon QR is also 1 upon 2. And AC upon PQ is also 1 upon 2. That means, students, when the triangles are similar, when the triangles are similar, okay, the corresponding sides are in proportion. Proportion means they form equal ratios, okay? So we can conclude AB upon PR is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. Corresponding sides of similar triangle are in proportion. Students, what do you mean by proportion? Unka jo numerator upon denominator ka answer aata hai, that will remain the same. The ratios will be equal. So students, we have learned two things now. One is relation of angles and one is relation of sides. Okay. What we have studied in relation of angles. If two triangles are similar, then their corresponding sides are in proportion. So students will get AB upon PR is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PQ. So students, whenever you have two triangles similar, corresponding sides are always in proportion. And whenever you have two triangles similar, their corresponding angles will be congruent. Okay. Now, students, we have triangle ABC similar to triangle QRP. That is already given. So, students, if triangles are similar, we have to write the ratios about their sides. So, which are the first two alphabets, students, here? The answer, dekho, AB. So, the name of the first side will be AB. So, AB ka, tell me, students, corresponding side kya hoga? Yahan pe hum log ne first two liya hai. To yahan pe bhi first two lene ka. Look at the first two things. QR. So, AB upon QR will be equal to, abhi main next side lunga, BC. BC is last two terms. So, look at the last two terms here. Tell me, students, kya hai last two terms? Yes, it is RP. So, BC upon RP is equal to first and last. Look at the first and last term, students. Yes, that is AC. AC ka corresponding side, kaunsa hoga? QP. So, students, whenever the triangles are similar, corresponding sides are in proportion. What do we write the reason as? CSST. C dot S dot S dot T. Corresponding sides of similar triangle. CSST. Corresponding sides, similar triangles. Okay. What do you know about corresponding sides of similar triangle? They are in proportion. Means your corresponding side ka ratios, they will always be equal to each other. Okay. Same way, student, if two corresponding sides are congruent, same way if two triangles are similar, corresponding angles are also congruent. Okay. Angle A will be congruent to angle Q, first alphabet with first. Tell me, students, angle B will be congruent to which angle? Yes, it will be congruent to R. And angle C will be congruent to which angle? Yes, it will be congruent to P. Iska reason aega, corresponding angles of similar triangle. What do you know about corresponding angles of similar triangle? They are always congruent. Angles of similar triangles are congruent. And sides of similar triangle are in proportion. Iska short form mein reason likhenge, CAST. Corresponding angles of similar triangles. So last ka jo ST hai, that is for similar triangles. All students, I'll give you exactly 1 minute. Give the heading similar triangles and write down this. Okay. I hope all the students have written this. Okay. Students, I hope all of you have written this. So students, what have we studied till now? We have studied something about similar triangles. Tell me, what are similar triangles? Triangles having same shape but different size. Figures or triangles having same shape but different size are such figures are called as similar figures. Right now we are studying only about similar triangles. If two triangles are similar, their corresponding sides, their matching sides are always in proportion. Proportion means unka jo ratios hai, that will be equal, and jo corresponding angles hai, they will always be congruent. The corresponding angles will always be congruent. Okay. Students, I want all of you to come to practice set 3.5, question number 1. Take out your textbook. Come to practice set 3.5, question number 1. In practice set 3.5, you have 3 questions, and all the 3 questions are very, very simple, and all the 3 questions have weightage of 2 marks. Okay. So students, we start with practice set 3.1. Practice set 3.5, question number 1. Okay. Students, we have triangle XYZ. It is similar to triangle LMN. So students, XYZ and LMN, these two triangles are similar. Okay. So I draw a rough figure of triangle XYZ and a rough figure of triangle LMN. When you draw the figure, students, you have to draw in a such a way the figure should look same. Unka jo shape hai, that should look same. Agar aapne ek, I'm just giving an example. Agar aapne ek equilateral triangle banaya, to dusra aap scalene triangle nahi bana sakte. So the figure should look same. Size different ho sakta hai. Ek chota, ek bada ho sakta hai. But the figure should look same. Okay. So student, triangle XYZ and triangle LMN, these two triangles are similar. So triangle XYZ is similar to triangle LMN. We are supposed to write their corresponding angles of two triangles and also write the ratios of corresponding sides. Okay. Now students, you will tell me, first we'll concentrate on corresponding angles. Okay. And we can start with corresponding sides also. Now students, you will tell me, look at the first two alphabets, XY. Tell me XY ka corresponding side, XY ka matching side, kaun sa hoga? Come on students, I want answers from you. XY ka corresponding side. Yes, it will be LM. So XY upon LM is equal to, tell me students, YZ ka corresponding side kaun sa hoga? Yes, super. YZ ka corresponding side will be MN. YZ upon MN is equal to, tell me students, which will be the corresponding side of XZ? Yes, it will be LM. Can any students tell me the reason for this? We were given that the triangles are similar and we have written corresponding sides are in proportion. What will be the reason? Yes, superb, great. The reason will be CSST. corresponding sides of similar triangles. Students, we are also supposed to write the corresponding angles. Tell me students, x ka corresponding angle kaun sa hoga? Angle x ka corresponding angle? Yes, it will be m. Tell me students, what will be the corresponding angle of y? Yes, it will be m. And which will be the corresponding angle of z? Yes, it will be n. So angle x will be congruent to angle l, y will be congruent to m, and z will be congruent to n. So corresponding side angles, corresponding angles of similar triangles are always congruent. So x will be congruent to l, y will be congruent to m, and z will be congruent to n. And the reason for all these three will be, tell me students, what will be the reason? Yes, the reason will be CAST, corresponding angles of similar triangles. Kiske corresponding angles hai? Of similar triangles. Okay. All students, please draw the figure and write down the solution. Every student is supposed to draw the figure and write down the solution. I'll just give you 2 minutes for this. Okay. Any student has any doubt till here? Any student has any doubt till here? Okay, super. All students, please draw the figure and write down the solution. This sum will can come in your school exam for 2 months. Okay? All of you, please start with the sum. First, you will draw the figure and then you will write the solution. I'll give you exactly 2 minutes to complete this. Okay, students, I hope all of you have drawn the figure and writing the solution part. Those who are done with the first sum can read the question of question number two, can read question number two and try to solve question number two on your own. It is a very, very simple thing. Okay, students, let's proceed further. Those who are still writing, please complete it fast. I'll give you all more 45 seconds and then I'll proceed further to the next sum. Those who are done with the first sum can try the second sum. This concept, similarity, you're going to learn in detail in your 10th standard, chapter number 1. The name of the chapter itself is similarity. Okay. Okay, students, let us start with the next sum. That is practice set 3.5, question number 2. It's a very, very simple sum. So I want each student to pay attention for this. Triangle in triangle XYZ. So students, we have a triangle XYZ where length of XY is 4 centimeter. Length of YZ, okay, length of YZ is 6 centimeter and length of XZ is 5 centimeter. That much is given to us. Aisa question mein diya hua hai. Triangle XYZ is similar to triangle PQR. So students, when I draw the figure, XYZ and PQR are similar triangles. So when you draw the figures, both the figures should look same. Okay. Inka size different hoga chalega, but their shape should look same. Okay. So we have a triangle PQR, where PQ is given as 8 centimeter. The length of PQ is given as 8 centimeter. We are supposed to find length of QR and PR. We are supposed to find length of PR and QR. Okay. Let us start with this, students. What do you know about both the triangles? Triangles are similar. Triangle XYZ is similar to triangle PQR. The triangles are similar. That information is already given to us. Okay. Now, students, we know if triangles are similar, we can get relation about their angles and we can get relation about their sides. Okay. Here we are more interested to get relation of their sides. What do we know about sides of similar triangle? What do we know about, if I'm being more specific, what do we know about corresponding sides of similar triangle? Yes, corresponding sides of similar triangle are in proportion. Okay. So students, we have XY upon PQ. Okay. Tell me, student, which is the corresponding side of YZ? Which is the corresponding side of YZ? Yes, it is PQ. And which is the corresponding side of XZ? XZ ka corresponding side. Yes, it is PR. So students, if triangles are similar, corresponding sides are in proportion, XY upon PQ is equal to YZ upon QR is equal to XZ upon PR. The reason for this will be CSST, corresponding sides of similar triangle. Okay. Now students, let us substitute the values. In place of XY, I'm going to write 4. In place of PQ, look at PQ. How much is PQ given us? Yes, 8 is equal to YZ. Look at YZ. Yes, it is 6 upon QR will remain as it is because we don't know length of QR. In place of XZ, XZ ki jagah pe kya aega? 5 upon PR. Okay. Now students, we are going to solve the first two terms and get the answer for QR. 4 upon 8 is equal to 6 upon QR. So student, to find the length of QR, we need to do cross multiplication. 4 into QR is equal to 8 into 6. 4 yahan pe multiplication mein idhar aayega to kya ho jayega? Division. So QR is equal to what? 6 into 8 upon 4. Students, I want you all to do the calculation and give me the answers. First, you're going to draw the figures, give the heading solution, double underline the heading solution, start writing. Once you're done till here, please find the length of QR and give me the answer in the chat box. I want all the students to be very fast. Okay. Draw the figure as shown on the screen. Write the solution. When you write the solution, you are going to find length of QR on your own. Okay, students, start writing and give me the answer for QR. Every student is first supposed to draw the figure, only then you will start with the solution. Okay. Students, let's proceed further. 4 multiplication method, I got to division. So QR will become 6 into 8 upon 4. 6 eggs are 48 upon 4. So students, let's divide 48 by 4. 48 divided by 4. What is our answer, students? Yes, the length of QR is 12 centimeter. Okay, so students, we have got length of QR. Now we are just supposed to find one thing, that is PR. I hope all the students have written till here. Those who are still writing, please complete it fast, last 45 seconds. Those who are done can try to find out PR. Try to find out PR on your own and give me the answer. Let's see how many of you will give the answer for PR. Okay, I hope all of you are done till QR. Next, students, we will take 4 upon 8 is equal to 5 upon PR. 4 upon 8 is equal to 5 upon PR. Again, we are going to do the same thing, that is cross multiplication. So we'll get 4 into PR is equal to 5 into 8. Okay. Students, quickly solve. You are not going to draw a line and write beside that. You have to write one below the other. So once you are done with QR, usi ke niche you are going to write 4 upon 8 is equal to 5 upon PR. You are going to do cross multiplication and you are going to give me the answer. Okay. I want all of you all to write it very nicely and present it very well. All the final answers will be in the box. QR is equal to 12 centimeter in box. PR is equal to dash. Okay, that will also be in the box. You have to present the sum very nicely. Figure, solution, entire thing, presentation should be very good. Come on, students, I've started getting answers and waiting for the answers from other students also. Yes, I've started getting many answers. Superb. Yes, PR is equal to 10 is the correct answer. 5 into 8 will give you 40. 4 multiplication, either I got to division. 40 divided by 4. PR is equal to 10 centimeter. Okay. So students, QR is equal to 12 centimeter and PR is equal to 10 centimeter. Those answers will be in the box. Okay. All students, quickly complete the sum. I'll just give you a last 1 minute. I want all of you all to complete this sum. And then we are going to start with the next sum. Okay. Okay, students, I hope all of you are done with this sum. I'm proceeding towards the next sum. So students, this topic which we are doing right now is very, very simple, right? We just need to remember, if two triangles are similar, listen carefully students, if two triangles are similar, corresponding sides are in proportion. If two triangles are similar, corresponding sides will always be in proportion. And if two triangles are similar, their corresponding angles will always be congruent. Corresponding sides will be in proportion and corresponding angles will be congruent. Corresponding sides will be in proportion and corresponding angles will be congruent. Okay. Let us do the next sum, students. Practice set 3.5, question number 3. Okay. It's a sum which is based on construction. So I want each and every student to pay attention for this. Draw a sketch of pair of similar triangles, label them, show their corresponding angles by same sign, show their length of corresponding side by numbers in proportion. Let us understand this, students. First, we will draw a sketch of our similar triangles. So students, you have to draw the figures in such a way that they should look and they should be similar. What do you mean by similar? Figures should have a same shape and they should have a same size. So you can draw either an equilateral triangle or isosceles triangle, acute angle, obtuse angle or right angle or a scalene triangle. But agar aapne ek acute banaya to dusra bhi acute hoga. Ek equilateral triangle banaya to dusra bhi equilateral triangle hoga. Okay? Show their corresponding angles by same sign. Okay? So student, triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Tell me students, angle A ka corresponding angle kaun sa hai? Yes, it is P. So angle A will be congruent to angle P. So I've shown A and P by same sign. If you look at the figure, they're having identical mark. Okay, what do you mean by identical mark? Same sign. Okay. Angle B will be congruent to angle Q. Angle B will be congruent to angle Q because B ka corresponding angle is Q. Now students, look at B and Q. To B and Q, I've put a same sign. Okay. Angle C will be congruent to. Tell me students, what is the corresponding angle of C? Corresponding angle of C. Yes, it is R. So angle C will be congruent to R. So C or R ke upar dekho, maine same marking dala hai. A or P pe marking same hai. B or Q pe bhi marking same hai. We have dot dot. And C or R pe bhi marking same hai. We have cross cross. Okay. Reason will be CAST. The full form of CAST is corresponding angle of similar triangle. Okay. Now students, I want all of you to draw the figure. It's okay if you don't take the measurement and draw, but students, please make sure the figure should look same. Okay. You don't need to take any measures or length. You have to just draw the rough figures. But the rough figures should be looking similar. Aisa nahi hona chahiye ki aapka ek right angle triangle aur dusra equilateral triangle hai. No. Both the triangles should look similar. So students, I want you to draw two similar triangles and write down the solution till here. After drawing the figure, you have to also put an identical mark. A or P pe same marking, B or Q pe same marking, and C or R pe same marking. सेम मार्किंग को हम मैथमेटिक्स टर्म ज्योमेट्रिक टर्म में बोलते हैं आइडेंटिकल मार्क. आइडेंटिकल मार्क का मतलब क्या होता है? सेम मार्किंग्स. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, प्लीज ड्रॉ द फिगर एंड राइट डाउन द सॉल्यूशन टिल हियर. ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, प्लीज ड्रॉ द फिगर एंड राइट डाउन द सॉल्यूशन टिल हियर. students, please understand your figures should look similar. Okay. Last 1 minute, please draw it fast. Okay, now students, I want all of you all to pay attention. Show the length of corresponding side by numbers in proportion. We have to show their length of corresponding sides by number in proportion. Iska matlab kya hota hai? We have to show AB and PQ are in proportion. So hame AP aur PQ ka length iske hisab se lena padega, that they should be in proportion. Okay. अगर मैंने ए बी को 4 सेंटीमीटर लिया है, सो आई एम टेकिंग पी क्यू एस 8 सेंटीमीटर. सो स्टूडेंट टेल मी व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन 4 एंड 8. कैन आई से 4 का डबल किया तो 8 मिलेगा. सो स्टूडेंट्स, अगर एक साइड के लिए मैंने डबल किया है तो बाकी सब साइड के लिए मुझे डबल करना पड़ेगा, बिकॉज करस्पॉन्डिंग साइड ऑफ सिमिलर ट्राइंगल आर ऑलवेज इन प्रोपोर्शन. मैंने एक साइड का लेंथ 4 अज्यूम किया तो उसका जो करस्पॉन्डिंग साइड है वो मैंने 4 का डबल किया. अगर मैं एक साइड पे थ्राइस करता, 4 का इनटू 3 करता तो 12 करता, तो सब साइड के लिए मुझे क्या करना पड़ता, इनटू 3. सो AB अपॉन PQ इज 4 अपॉन 8. 4 अपॉन 8 इज नथिंग बट 1 अपॉन 2. अगर मैंने स्टूडेंट्स BC को 5 लिया है तो QR शुड बी डबल ऑफ 5. ओके, 5 का डबल, टेल मी स्टूडेंट्स कितना आएगा? यस, इट विल बी 10. सो इट विल बी BC अपॉन QR. नाउ 5 अपॉन 10, स्टूडेंट्स टेल मी व्हाट इज 5 अपॉन 10? यस, 5 अपॉन 10 इज आल्सो 1 अपॉन 2. इफ आई टेक AC इज 6, 6 का डबल, स्टूडेंट्स टेल मी 6 का डबल कितना होता है? Yes, it will be 12. So 6 upon 12. What is 6 upon 12? That is also 1 upon 2. So each ratio is 1 upon 2. So I say AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR, because the ratio of each side is now 1 upon 2. Agar aapko double nahi lena hai, students, you can take half. You can take into 3, into 4, आप कोई भी नंबर से, बट अगर एक साइड के लिए आपने into 3 किया तो सब साइड के लिए into 3 करना पड़ता है, because corresponding sides of similar triangles are always in proportion. Proportion means उनका ratio equal रहेगा. Okay? All students, please write down this. Please give all the labelings and markings in the figure. I have written length of each side. Please, students, write that in your figure and complete the solution also. I'll give you all more 2 minutes, okay? I want all the students to be very fast. Put all the markings and write down the solution till here. Okay, student, this was a very important topic. No doubt we have only 3 sums based on this, but I want you all to revise this 3 sums again. Practice this 3 sums, because this is very, very important for your 10th standard. Okay, so students, we have learned what do you mean by similar objects. Figures which have same shape, any figures which have same shape but different size, size can be different, size can be same also, but the shape should always be same. Such figures are called as similar figures. And what do you mean by similar triangles? Triangles having same shape, but they have or they may not have different size. Such figures, such triangles are known as similar triangles. If triangles are similar, there is a relation between their angles, between their corresponding angles, and there is a relation between their corresponding sides. Okay. If triangles are similar, their corresponding angles are congruent. Corresponding ka matlab hota hai matching angles are congruent and corresponding sides are in proportion. Proportion means they will form an equal ratios. So students, which are the important concept of the chapter? We first started with in the chapter, the first concept was sum of measures of all angle of a triangle is 180 degree. Then we have done remote interior angle theorem. Then we have done test of congruency. Kaun se different test hai. There are 5 tests of congruency. You need to remember all the 5 names. The first one was SSS. Second one is SAS. Third one was ASA. Fourth one was SAA. And the fifth one was hypotenuse side test. So these were the 5 tests of congruency. Then we have studied something about isosceles triangle theorem, converse of isosceles triangle theorem. We have done the proof of that theorem. Okay. Then we have something called as inequalities in the chapter, that is practice set 3.4, which is not very important and not at all important for 10th standard. Bahut sare schools mein omit bhi rehta hai. And the last one was 3.5, that is similarity. Okay. So students, I want you all to practice this chapter very nicely. It's very, very important chapter, especially jo congruency wala part hai that we are learning right from 8th standard is very important for your further chapters as well as for your 10th standard also. Okay. So students, today we are done with this chapter. We will stop here. Wishing you all a very happy Diwali and prosperous New Year in advance. Hopefully, we'll meet again soon. Okay. Bye, students. Thank you for your involvement in Maths Camp. Bye, Mahesh Tutorials. Thank you, everyone. Have a great day.